Hi everyone, I'm Ellie from Code of the Future, and today I'm going to show you how to get started in GitHub. So GitHub is a place where you can upload your code, you can share your code with other people, you can also find other people's code. It's also a great thing to put on your CV as well. If you have been doing the mini projects on my tutorial series, then you can upload the code, upload your code onto GitHub, put it on your CV, and then that is a portfolio in a sense for your employer to see that you are learning how to code. So as always, I'm going to get straight into the video, put my glasses on, and I'm going to move you onto the screen. Okay, so we've just opened up a web browser. It can be any web browser you want. So what you're going to type in is GitHub. Okay, and we're going to go into GitHub and we're going to click on this one here. Okay, and it'll pop up with this. Okay. So this is where the world builds software. So millions of developers and companies build, ship and maintain their software on GitHub, the largest and most advanced development platform in the world. So that is a bit of an overview of GitHub. So what you're going to do is you're going to go into sign up. So it'll pop up with something like this. So you're going to input any username you want. So for this channel, I'm going to create one called Code of the Future, just so then you, if you're watching any of my videos, will see all of my source code on this account. So I'll put a link in the description box to the Code of the Future account. There will be some code from the previous videos I've taught. So some of the tutorials I've done already, the code from that will be on GitHub. Yes, perfect. Okay, Code of the Future is now with some hyphens. Okay, perfect. Now I'm just going to put my personal details, email address and password, and then we'll continue with this, and then I'll click Create Account. So we're just going to do that now. Okay, so I filled in my details and we're going to click Create Account. So it's creating the account, okay, and this is where you can say exactly what you do. So for me, I am a student, but I am teaching as well, so I'm just gonna, I'm gonna put teacher because this account is specific to helping other people. So we're gonna put teacher, and then how much programming experience do you have? So personally, I have quite a bit, so you know, for you it might be that you don't program a lot or you're new to it. I'm gonna put a lot, but most of you will probably be in this bracket here where, you know, you do a bit. Okay, so what do you plan to use your GitHub for? Okay, so there's a whole range of different things. So I'm just going to say learn to code because that is what most of you will be putting as well. And then you can just pop in here, you know, what you're interested in. So you could put Python, data, you could put data science, anything like that. You can pop in whatever you're interested in here. And then we'll click complete setup and it'll be completing the setup. So what it will ask you to do is verify your email address. So I'm going to do that really quickly now. Okay, so once you've verified your email address, it'll pop up with this here. So it'll say, what do you want to do first? So you can start a new project and everything else. So what I'm going to do is create a repository. Okay, so what a repository is essentially like a folder. In that folder, you can upload any kind of files, any Python files. So what I can say is I'm going to put Python beginner tutorials, and then I'm going to put in brackets YouTube. Okay, it's going to be public so anybody can find, and I'm going to say snippets of code from the Python beginner tutorial series on Code of the Future's YouTube account. Perfect. So this is public, anybody can see. You can add a readme file, but for now I'm just going to create the repository. And it's doing so. Okay, so most of this may look a little bit daunting to you. For me, it took a bit of time to understand what was going on. But what I'm going to show you is we're just going to go up to the top here, and this will tell you exactly, you know, you're signed in as this. So you're going to go down to your profile, and this is your profile here. So you can add a picture, you can edit your profile. It says that I joined 4 minutes ago. You can also put it on dark mode, which makes it look like this, which I think is pretty cool. But for the ease of this video, I'm just going to keep it bright just so you can see what's going on. So yeah, I discovered dark mode. So what this is, this overview here will tell you kind of all your repositories will be put here. You can customize them, so you can put the ones that are most important to you here. This will tell you how much you've contributed in the last year. So on my main one, I think I've had like 400 contributions in the past year. Something that's really handy with these contributions in the last year is employers can see this. So if you put on your CV, here's my GitHub account, and you have a lot of contributions, your employer can see that, you know, you've been very active, you've been doing a lot of coding, you've been uploading a lot. Okay. So here, this is a little bit of contribution activity. It says I created my first repository and I joined GitHub today. Okay, so you'll click on repositories, and this is the first repository here. We'll click on it, and obviously it comes up with this again. So there's nothing in here at the moment. This is why it's coming up with these kind of hints here, or create a new repository. you know, all this stuff. So what you will do is you will go to here where it says get started by creating a new file or uploading an existing file. So I'm going to upload an existing file, and it comes up with this here. So it says drag files here to add them to your repository. So you could drag them from your desktop onto here, but I'm just going to choose my files instead. So I'm on my desktop. I've got a folder already called Python codes, and these are all the Python codes that I have at the moment. This is a copy, so I'm just going to go back on my desktop, and we're going to just delete that one because it's a copy of the one I already have here. And we're going to select all these, and we're going to click open, and GitHub is uploading all of these Python files here. Perfect. Then you're going to, once it's done, so once it's finished uploading them, you're going to click commit changes, and it's processing your file, so it may take a couple of minutes. It depends on how much you're uploading. Okay, so it's doing it, it's uploading them, and perfect, there we go. So this is you here, this will be you, so that's me. This is your repository, and these here are the repositories. So let's say we'll go on the quiz that I did in the previous video, and there we go, here's all the Python code. So if you, you know, had done the quiz yourself and you wanted the answers, all you could do is literally copy and paste this and input it into your Python file. Perfect. So this is a way, this is the very basic way of GitHub. This is how you upload things. So say you have, you know, you have this, we have a repository. Say you have a repository for your Python files, and then you're learning another programming language on the side, and you don't want them all together, you want another repository. The way that you do that is you'll go into your repositories, and you'll click new, and then you'll do the exact same thing, input your what repository name it wants to be, and create the repository. Okay, so because this is part of the beginner series, I'm keeping the GitHub very basic at the moment, just how you can create an account, upload files, create repositories and things like that. So we can change this. I quite like that, it's an upside down smiley face. So you can change your avatar, you can upload your own photo, you can add edit profile, add some things in here, which is what I will do, you know, after this video to make it look a little bit nicer. This is basically all you need to know to be able to upload your own code to GitHub. Something you can do is, you know, copy the link here and then post it on your link on your LinkedIn or on your CV and say, look, I do code, here's my GitHub. But just make sure to make your GitHub look impressive. Don't make it look messy. You want it to look nice, and you want it to look like you've done a lot of coding. So that's how you can set up your own GitHub account. Something that's really handy in GitHub is you can search for other people's code. So let's say you want to put in here, you can search. So let's say for the sake of the video that I hadn't done a rock paper scissors video and I wanted to learn how to do it. Paper scissors, okay. So this top line will say in this user, so it will search for anything related to rock paper scissors in my user. But what you'll want to do is click all GitHub, and there we go, we have 35,000 repositories all that have something to do with rock paper scissors here. Most of them are in JavaScript, but if you want to do Python, we'll click down to Python and it will give you all the Python ones, and you can kind of find ones for you. Some of these may be very kind of too hard, you know, sometimes you look at code and think, gosh, that is not, you know, that's not beginner. So you could similarly put in here beginner, we'll click all of GitHub, and there we go, simple Python code of rock paper scissors can be understood by beginners. And again, you know, you'll pop in Python and it'll pop up. So perfect, that is how you can search in GitHub. That is how you create a GitHub account, how you upload your own GitHub code, how you create more than one repository, and how you also search in GitHub and find other code. So that is the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then please like, subscribe and comment. And thank you again for everyone that has watched all my tutorial series videos. I've got massive plans for this YouTube channel, so I'm really happy that you've kickstarted my YouTube channel off with me. So thank you, and I'll see you all in the next video.